Hi, so I thought I'd explain how you might choose a good WordPress plugin. There's lots and lots of plugins for everything you'd want to do in WordPress, and sometimes it's not very easy to pick one. So, and picking the right one can be a very good thing. It can be the difference between something that will bog your site down and something that will really help your site soar. The way you pick a WordPress plugin is, at least the way I pick it, I've been using WordPress for a long, long time, and so I've been looking at plugins forever. There are several things here that can help you choose one. Basically, let's say you're looking for a forms plugin. So you want a form, like a contact form. So type in form in the search here. So there's all of these plugins. How do you choose one? So basically, it's impossible to choose one just by looking in here. I mean, you can pick one and hope it's good. A couple of things I look for is when it was last updated, because this means that it has active development on it. So it means the developer has paid attention to it. They care about the plugin. They're trying to make it better. So that's a good indicator that a plugin is still in good repair, and the developer has really worked on it. 5 months ago is not a great time frame. 2 months ago might be okay, it depends. But I'd rather do ones like this that's a day ago, because then you can tell, 11 hours ago, a week ago, these kind of things, you know that they've been working on it very frequently. So that helps. Another thing that helps too is how many stars it has. Of course, kind of like Amazon or anywhere, how many stars it has is how good it is. How many ratings it has. But also, here's another way to tell. Look at the downloads. Look at how many downloads it has, because this tells you that so many other people have heard of it and downloaded it and at least tried it. And so I would always, always, always choose 5 million downloads over 99,000. 99,000 is not bad either, but this one's far better. And especially when it says untested with your version and this one says compatible, it means that they've updated it recently. So this might be a good one to pick. The other way that you might choose a good plugin, let's see, forms plugin here. You can look through compatible with your version, updated a week ago. 111,000, pretty good reviews. That's fine. Another way that I would choose is I would go to the web and say, and go to Google and say, best WordPress forms plugin. And another good thing, I just saw that in the search box. Put in the year too, because I'm sure people have been writing best form WordPress plugin posts for the last 10 years or 5 years or whatever. And so you may not get a current, version of a post that'll tell you what's good this year, what's good in WordPress now, because maybe some plugins have fallen off in the past couple of years and they're not good anymore and you don't want to use those because they're not going to be good for your site. So if you look here, let's see, that's fairly recent. Opt-in forms, this is actually on WordPress.org, so you can look at that. But I tend to look for these right here. SitePoint is terrific. You can look here and find out all best posts. I don't really know that website as much, but they have a roundup of WordPress plugins for 2015. And then Code Canyon is good. Some of these other places I don't know as well, but it looks like they've done some work to tell you what's the best plugin. So let's just try SitePoint real quick. And so what I consider this similar to is kind of window shopping. And it's good to do that the first couple times you do WordPress plugins and install them. All right, I got all this jazz coming up. That's annoying. So if you look at this post, it was done in January 2015. And let's see. So Jetpack's contact form module, go away, New Relic. Jetpack is WordPress's .com software that you can install on your .org, which is pretty cool. So that might be worth doing. It looks like they have a pretty easy way to put a contact form in. Contact Form 7, I just know this plugin from using it for a long time, and seeing it on a lot of blogs and things like that. So I kind of know this one already because I've been kind of looking for plugins for years. But if you look at this, it says most popular plugins of 2014. That's a good clue that a lot of people got some really good use out of it. Usually the bad plugins that aren't coded well and don't do well, they typically don't make it onto websites a lot, and people, they get bad reviews and people just don't use it. But if you look here, 3.9 or higher, compatible up to 4.0.1. This doesn't mean that if you have 4.1 or 4.2, I can't remember what the latest is now, that doesn't mean that it's not compatible with the latest. It just means this is the last time they've updated it and they've looked at this as a 4.0. And that's a good clue because, you know, it's fairly recent, so it's probably going to be fine. Things in WordPress don't change quite that much from version to version. Typically from 3 to 4 they do, but from 4 to 4.1, there's not tons of updates that will break things usually. And then downloads, 22 million downloads is killer. That's a great forms plugin. So I would either pick contact form 7 or go back here, or fast secure contact form, because this has 5 million. That's not quite as much. So you can tell from here, contact form 7 is probably the best. It has all kinds of stuff: Ajax powered submission, CAPTCHA, Akismet spam filtering, which is actually really excellent. That's by the WordPress team as well. So you can look at some of these other things. This one has a lot of downloads. It's compatible with a lot of the latest ones. Fast Secure is here as well. You can look at that and see that they've been updating it too. A couple months old is okay. Just, you can kind of find a good plugin this way by looking and seeing, you know, what people are actually installing, and just kind of use that like social proof of everybody else has done this. And so, you know, that's going to be a good indicator that maybe you should use that plugin as well. So, there's a ton of roundups on the web. If you look here again on Google, of course, Google is your friend. Once again, that's a universal rule in technology. But you can look at all of these kind of roundups to find out, you know, what are the best plugins? What are people using out there? And that really helps you to pick the best plugin for whatever you're looking for. This just doesn't just apply to forms. This applies to all kinds of things. But that is, in effect, the best way to pick a plugin. And that's what I've been doing with WordPress for a long time. And it's really helped me. So I hope that helps. And let me know if you have any questions or anything. I would love to help you out and maybe help you pick a plugin if you need help with that. And let me know. And happy WordPressing.